Hi, as parents and as teachers, there is one thing that we are very worried about as far as our children are concerned, and that is their reading habit. We want to inculcate good reading habits in our... First of all, let's understand, why do we want our children to read? How is reading different from watching a movie? When we read, we just see a two-dimensional structure. It's open a vast avenue of imagination. The child is able to construct an entire world in his mind, whereas a three-dimensional movie experience doesn't allow that. Everything is already imagined for the child. Okay. Let's look at the types of readers that we come across. First of all, let's look at those people reading. They like reading, you can say, or they love reading. And then there are those who are told to read. You know, somebody tells you, read. And you feel that it's a... As a child, I loved reading. And I wanted my son to do the same. So I started buying books for him. Before he even turned one. See, this is one of the first books that I bought, ABCD, but all these colorful kind of pictures. Then I used to show him real life boxes and jars as in the picture. You know, I used to teach him colors, yellow, red, blue. I thought that was a good way of introducing a book to him. I got a picture word book. See, what does a theater look like, and how does a circus, this is a trip to a circus, all these things, a trip to a circus, then neighbors. I used to take him to the neighbor's house and teach him, they are neighbors. This is how things are kept in the room. The different types of rooms. So I associated real life things with things in the books. So the first thing that he learned was that a book is a representation of reality. This is another word book I got. He loved this page and would never let me turn over. Then I started buying books of my choice first. These were the animals that we don't see around, like a koala, dolphin. Then I had a panda, a brown bear, a tiger. I took him to a zoo also to make Alice in Wonderland, one of my favorite tales. Balloons for me. And I got this because he hated balloons as a child. In fact, he was scared of them. I got Goldilocks. Even one which had pop-outs in it. And that was the book he always used to look at when he was eating his food, which he didn't like, of course. Then he started... He never liked this book. He never liked this one. Never, never, never. These are all books that I got for him. I used to read stories out, but it didn't work. This was my favorite when I was a child. It's not then. One day, we went to a bookstore together. One day, we walked in a mall in... My favorite still lies unread. Just imagine. Then, I got a flood of books on cars in my house. I've given most of them away, but I still have some because he wouldn't let me touch them. Supercars. He would know everything about cars, which is the fastest one, which is the most expensive one. Cars that I hadn't heard of. Motorbikes. Then came this one. Monster Machine. Just see, at first time I saw he still wouldn't read the way I wanted him to. Like a habit, he wouldn't read regularly. These are books just which I would rate as informative ones. They're not the ones that you want your child to read as a parent, which enhances his creative, cognitive and thinking abilities. No, they don't. Well, this is Enid Blyton's The Enchanted Wood. I bought this book and it kept lying for many days till I took the initiative, picked it up and read it page by page as a bedtime story. He would like this book so much that he didn't want the second standard at that time, or one. He says one. And the Folk of the Faraway Tree, them. Along with that, he also reads this one, The Diary of a Wimpy Kid. He's got plenty of these too, all filled in here. These are some other books that he always loved reading. They're comic books, Chota Bhim series. I don't know, he loved these books he wanted to read. So there was always a tussle between the parent and child. This is what I got for it. This is one thing that both of us like, whatever you read. I like to get these type of books which inspire. The books on the basis of which the child can create some ideal. One to reading is identifying the taste of a child. What does your child like and enjoy? Whatever he likes in real life, he would like to read about it too. My father was never fond of reading, but if you would give him any article on, say, health or sports, he would read it. He would even read big fat books because he's a health freak and he was a sportsman. The same thing goes to my people who are not too fond of reading, read things on topics that they love. So the first step to make your child love reading is to identify his interest. You have to tell your child to read, it's not actually completing the mission. Your child should not be told to read, he should love reading. So the point is that anyone would read if he likes that particular topic. So to inculcate love for reading, it's very important to understand the interest of the reader. That is what creates love for reading. If you have to tell, oh, read, 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 it becomes burdensome. Instead of saying, do, 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 create the love and interest. That's the most important thing. The second thing that I would say is, maintain a regularity. Say, start from 5 or 10 or say 15 minutes. 15 minutes a day, anytime. You can start with bedtime with children or anybody for that matter. People who started reading at bedtime as children still do that. They read themselves to sleep and it triggers the imagination. It keeps on working in the mind. So that's what it is. Make a routine. And point number 3, don't give up. Winners never quit and quitters never win. So that is the motto. We should also keep in mind one more thing, that whatever you select for reading, for the child of course, should not be too high. It shouldn't be higher than his level, otherwise he won't understand. And it should not be too low. If it's too low, he will not gain anything and lose interest. So setting, understanding the level of the child is also very important. So we need to do that. And just don't give up. And last of all, I repeat this in fact, don't put the pressure on the child. Just let him be. Introduce the love for learning. That opens the doors to an entire world of imagination and creativity. Thank you.